Hi, let's talk about the laryngeal cavity. So the laryngeal cavity is the space through which air moves in the larynx. So to the right here, we can see a posterior view of the larynx invested by mucosa. So I'll outline. There's the epiglottis. There are the arytenoid cartilages. They're sitting atop the cricoid cartilage. The walls of the laryngopharynx have been incised and are being pulled laterally. Superiorly here, this would be the palatopharyngeal folds, the uvula. This rugose area is the root of the tongue. The spaces here, if we were to pull the epiglottis posteriorly, that would reveal the epiglottic vesiculi. And the interarytenoid notch is this space here that I'm outlining in between the mucosa-covered arytenoid cartilages. So if we were to take the entirety of this space, so here are the airy epiglottic folds going from the arytenoid cartilage up to the epiglottis laterally. It's within those airy epiglottic folds that one can find the cuneiform cartilages. But if we were to take this entire space here and outline it, that would be the laryngeal inlet. So that's the space through which air can move in and out of the larynx, which is contiguous with the laryngopharynx. Laterally here, so we can see some spaces that are within the laryngopharynx. There's one of them. These are the piriform recesses, or the piriform fossae. These are areas in which food may get trapped. So during deglutition, the larynx is going to elevate, and that's going to come into contact with this epiglottic cartilage so as to prevent the movement of food or beverage into that laryngeal inlet. With a lot of luck, that material travels inferiorly or distally down the esophagus to the stomach. But from time to time, materials may get trapped in these piriform recesses, which can be very uncomfortable for an individual. So let's take a look at this same region with the larynx incised. So as we can see here and here, the posterior aspect of the cricoid cartilage has been incised and reflected laterally. We can see still the epiglottis here. The arytenoid cartilages would be there and there, invested with mucosa. So as air moves in and out of the larynx through that laryngeal inlet, it's going to be moving through a space, I'll just outline it there, called the laryngeal vestibule. distal to the laryngeal vestibule, we're going to have the vestibular folds, also known as the false vocal folds. You can see them there and there. These are the vestibular ligaments that are running from the arytenoid cartilages to the thyroid cartilage, and these are going to be invested with mucosae. The space between these false vocal folds, or the vestibular folds, is known as the Rema Vestibuli. As we move inferior to the Rema Vestibuli and those false vocal folds, we see empty space. That empty space is the laryngeal ventricle, and we can't see it in this particular photograph, but it is much more extensive laterally than we can appreciate here. Immediately below the laryngeal ventricle are the vocal folds. The vocal folds are what vibrate during phonation. So there are vocal ligaments which are invested with mucosae that have some muscle associated with them, and they're oftentimes referred to as vocal cords. The space between the vocal folds is known as the Rema Glottis or Rema Glottis. So that's the space that's rather dynamic as the arytenoid cartilages either pivot or slide. It can become more or less patent depending on activities. If there's movement of air for breathing versus movement of air for phonation. And then inferior to these vocal folds and the Rema Glottis is a region known as the infra glottic cavity. And this will extend down to the inferior margin of the coracoid cartilage. So as one can imagine, this infraglottic cavity is contiguous with the lumen of the trachea. And so on the way out, air will pass from the trachea to the infraglottic cavity. It will move through the Rema Glottis, through the laryngeal ventricle, through the Rema Vestibuli, through the laryngeal ventricle vestibule, out the laryngeal inlet, and it will be then conducted via the pharynx, which is part of that aerodigestive pathway. The reverse air can be brought in either through the oral or nasal cavity into either the oropharynx or the nasopharynx. The oropharynx is contiguous with the nasopharynx and is contiguous with the laryngopharynx, which is contiguous with the larynx through the laryngeal inlet. Thank you for your time.